Flares, there's an emergency. My tank possibly has exploded. Well, Slayers, we're back at it with another Slay Adventure, and today is not a good day. Today, my tank exploded. Now, this is actually a day later. We saved it. Everything's okay, good to go. However, we did lose a member. Look, let me go ahead and show you guys what went down exactly last night. Flares, there's an emergency. My tank possibly has exploded. It actually, the level of water has dropped. There's water here, there's water under here. We're all tiled up. Not only that, unfortunately Ninja is not doing so good. I have no idea what's going on with him. It looks like he has a parasite. We have to treat him. We're gonna put him in a little quarantine tub, treat him. This is really bad.
I know.
We're like in the process of getting ready to go to Texas and everything like that, and this happened. And now the tank is still holding its integrity right now. But as you can see, guys, water streaks. It's leaking somewhere and it's not good. It's definitely leaking somewhere. So I'm very, very worried. This is actually a slowdown flow, believe it or not. There was a lot of water everywhere. So instead of recording this and everything, I'm gonna try to get it settled. We might have to take this to Wild World, the Farleys, catch them all fishing. Some of my friends, somebody's gonna have to help me out here. It's in the middle of the night, and I'm hoping that we can go ahead and get all these fish bags set to go, and someone comes to the rescue, because I'm really worried about my fish, but not only a fish. This is 90 gallons, and if it goes all over the place, this is not gonna be good. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, I'm trying to keep it together, because look at my boy. Our boy's not doing so good. Glassy-eyed. Dude, oh my God, I hope we can treat him. Yeah. This is out of nowhere. He was okay the other day when we got the tadpoles with Ryan, but this is insane. He's not doing good, guys. All right, guys, so Billy's gonna record for me. We're adding water here, just enough for Ninja. Not too high that he can jump, but this is natural. Lake water, it's always my savior. All right, this should be good enough. Since it's been hot and everything, the temperature's insane. We're gonna go ahead and get him out. All right, as you can see here, he's not doing good, and we need to go ahead and get him out. So I'm not gonna use a net. I'm gonna be very cautious, very careful, very quick, easy, simple.
Get out of the way.
Get him out. Please don't flap, please don't flap. Easy, easy. Dang, it's so far away from the tub. One.
Do you want me to push it?
No, we're good.
You got
two,
it?
Three.
All right, Ninja, go, buddy. Go.
All right, we got Ninja in here.
Okay, perfect. Aerators are right next to you.
Oh,
they're on the bed.
Oh, they're on. Okay, perfect. Right, thank you. Wait. Crap. We need batteries. We
don't have batteries are on the bed.
No, we're okay. Oh. I'm just going to go ahead and grab his pump. As you can see, this is a complete emergency situation, guys. All right. I didn't do anything to the gulpers. We're okay. Oh,
no,
water's getting me in places I don't like. Oh, God, the plug.
Alright,
I gotta calm down, guys. Come on, Ninja. Keep it together, buddy. Keep it together. So, guys, we have the Airstone. We're gonna have it all plugged up. He has a lot of space right now. We're gonna treat him, and hopefully in this water, we can go ahead and heal him, get him good to go, and then get him to my apartment as fast as possible. Like, so much stuff has to happen now that the tank is leaking, everything's leaking.
Keep it together, we're okay.
It's gonna be crazy, guys. So stay tuned. Oh my God, this is not what I intended to do today. Well, Slayers, after many water changes and medicating in a few hours, we got Ninja back to health. And on top of that, we did a mega water change. We went ahead and did something kind of crazy, and we worked real hard, and we got the perfect well water that we needed for Ninja to make sure he's okay. And he's doing really good, and I couldn't have done it without you, girl. Appreciate you. 100%, and I appreciate you, Slayers. On top of that, we do have some bad news. So in the process of trying to go ahead and drain this tank, dry it out, patch it up, this is also lake water. It's 90 gallons, so we carry like, I don't know, 90 plus 140, I don't know. We're really tired, as you can see. We've been at it, but we're missing a member, and unfortunately, guys, during this transition, we lost Mick Jagger.
A moment.
Mick Jagger went ahead and in the process of me draining the tank and getting them out of this tank and putting them in a cooler downstairs, we ended up actually having Mick Jagger jump from here and land right here. And that was it.
It's unfortunate.
It was so unfortunate. And this happens in the fish keeping world. The tank is no longer leaking. I don't know what it was. My parents made it seem like it exploded and everything like that. And under emergency, we went ahead and dealt with it. And that's kind of why I don't like having fish not with me at all times, because then I can actually observe them. So yeah, this is not good. I'm not happy at all whatsoever. The fish are okay, at least these, but we did lose McJagger in the process. There was a lot of water before. I mean, here's an example. This is soaked. I don't know if you guys can see, but there was a lot of water and stuff all over the place on top of trying to save this guy. So it was definitely an emergency. What we're gonna go ahead and do is cut from here, and I'm most likely gonna go ahead and do a recap and show you how everyone's doing a day after. As you can see, it was nothing but mayhem. It was crazy. Lily, you were going ahead and freaking out because our boy over here, Ninja, was not doing so good, as you guys saw, but now he's okay.
I'm so happy.
I am beyond ecstatic. Look at this. He's happy, he's swimming around, he's coming up to the top. Hey, we're over here. Ninja, hey, over here. I guess he doesn't want to listen to us. See, he's okay now. Look how close he is to the camera. Aww. See, are you okay, buddy? Are you okay? Oh, he wants, yeah, he was having a serious time yesterday evening. So it was out of this world. We had to go ahead, drain this crazy thing, add 90 gallons, which we obviously can't, because as you can see here, here's still some of the streaks. It's still kind of leaking from the top, but we were able to go ahead and get it situated temporarily before we go ahead and leave to Texas. And then this guy's okay. So, you okay, buddy? Look, we can pet him and everything, and he's fine. So it was honestly out of this world what we experienced, guys. And I just want to go ahead and let you guys know, like, you got to make sure everything is sealed before you go ahead and purchase tanks from Off-Road. Now, granted, this tank is from 2001. I've sealed it myself. And it's time to go ahead and take this tank down, reseal it to put it back up. Because as you can see, it has held a lot of fish over time. I mean, hundreds throughout the channel and everything. You know, drop by, the clowns, the big red tail that I had. Everything that I had used to live here, and everything is still thriving. So this is a great tank, just needs to get resealed. But we're really happy to go ahead and see Ninja back in action, ready to eat, ready to go. So once we get back from Texas and everything like that, we're gonna be doing a lot of cool feeding videos and enjoying time with Ninja. Now, I wanna go ahead and show you guys what's going on at the sleigh pad, in the garage. So many things are changing and new tanks are coming. So let's head over there. So we made it back at the sleigh pad, and check this out, guys. Check this out. We have our beautiful acrylic tank, which will be for the 90 gallon. Yes, everything that's inside of that 90 gallon will be going in here in this beautiful 150 gallon acrylic aquarium. Yes, let me see if I can turn the flash so you can see something cool. So in here we have our sump by Living Color. We have it all plumbed out. I just gotta get my pump, which I do have, get it good to go, get it cycled, get everything perfect so that we can go ahead and have monster fish in here. So what's going to be going in there is, again, the 90 gallon aquarium and other fish that are actually not too big, but big enough to survive and grow in here. Now we have this beautiful aquarium here that we got from OfferUp, which is amazing. It's like a beautiful, beautiful price. Honestly paid $50 for this amazing aquarium that's also plumbed, ready to go for some awesome fish or the crawfish, who knows. But let's go ahead and walk in here. It's still a mess and everything, but I've been working hard. And if you listen, guys, listen. You hear that? You hear that, guys? It's because the pond is running, it is cycling. We have everything here good to go. This is just some lava rock dirt that I gotta go ahead and scoop up into that filter. But look at that, flows good. We're gonna go ahead and add the air stones that I have in here. I have them soaking for a few hours. We're gonna go ahead and add a couple here to have maximum amount of flow and water agitation for our beautiful monster fish that we're gonna be getting back from Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch. And add him in there, and possibly some fish in the future, but this tank is ready, it is fish ready. It's been cycling for, I don't know, since the last time I went ahead and I made a video on this pond, but I also made some modifications. Check it out, guys. So we went ahead, drilled the holes. This is my entire system. I got 4,000 gallons running into this sump. Here I have lava rock. If I can open this up. Lava rock in here. Let me turn on the flash. Lava rock is in there, you can't see, but the flow is insane. I also have the tube running here like a little soda can straw, all the way through in there, all the way to the bottom, just like a canister filter. That's blowing up. It has holes at the bottom of that pipe, going all the way up, draining here. I'm gonna put a sponge But here's the flow. Look at that. Woo, baby. Close that up. Then in here, I have my movable media, which I'll also add a sponge and filter floss. And if you look here, my movable media is moving around. I made like a little box so that the media wouldn't float into the pond. So it's like a little lottery box, but look at that. I wasn't really happy about the setup I had before because at any day, the media could have went ahead and clogged drains, and therefore the entire pond could have been in the garage. And if I had fish in it, that would have been good. So I'm taking all the necessary precautions to make sure that none of our fish die. With that being said, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I like to go ahead and show you guys what's going on in my life and keep you updated. Again, it's a shame that we lost Mick Jagger in the struggle today. So if you guys want to go ahead and suggest more videos, stuff you want to go ahead and learn, if you want to give me a list, I mean, I can give you a list on all the stuff I used here. It's very, very inexpensive. I think I spent $400 and I have myself a beautiful 700 gallon aquarium. Again, thank you, Slayers. We're about to hit 300,000 subscribers. Couldn't have done it without each and every single one of you. And I'll see you in the next adventure. Booyah.